The DCI Network Series amplifier includes many features and benefits that can be configured using the Audio Architect software. In the next few minutes, we will go over many of these features in basic detail. Some of these features will have their own standalone video providing greater detail on setup and configuration, but for now, let's go over these features briefly to show a basic overview of the power inside a DCI Network Series amplifier. Double-click on the virtual representation of the amplifier to open up the default device panel. The default device panel is the home screen for that particular amplifier, providing basic monitoring and control on the surface, as well as links to all the amplifier's underlying DSP features. On the far left is the channel processing output faders. These faders can be controlled individually or linked together. Each channel also has its own mute button. To the right of the faders, you will find input and output meters. These meters show both RMS and peak signals. Above each channel is a clip indicator. Below these meters is a series of indicators showing the status of each amp channel. To the right of the output meters is the amplifier mode settings. This can be accessed by double-clicking on the mode block. The amplifier mode settings window allows the basic configuration of the amp to be set up. Input channels can be wired together in a variety of configurations, and the output channel pairs can be bridged. Additionally, the mode block allows for the high Z mode to be configured. Each channel can be either low Z, your typical 2, 4, 8, 16 ohm loads, or high Z for 70 or 100 volt loads. To the right of the mode block shows all of the customizable processing blocks in logical order from left to right. The first of these blocks is the input source routing block. This is where the source for the selected channel is chosen between any one of the many possible inputs, either analog or digital. Each channel has a drop-down list allowing any one of the analog inputs to be selected, any one of the digital inputs to be selected, or a mono sum of adjacent inputs. There are three levels of input priority, high, medium, and low, that can be configured as well. The next processing block is input delay. Up to 2 seconds of delay can be selected for each channel. The input delay is typically used for distance to destination delay. The delay can be entered in seconds, feet, or meters. Individual loudspeaker delay is best configured in the output delay block, covered in just a few moments. Continuing on is the input EQ. The input equalizer consists of 8 individual filters per channel. Each filter type is defaulted to the parametric EQ type, but can be changed to various other filter types. The input EQ is best used to EQ a room or venue. A thick white line shows the aggregate frequency response of the combined filter settings. EQ settings specific to the speaker, and not the room, are best set up using the output EQ, shown in just a few moments. The next block, and the first of the output processing blocks, is the crossover. The crossover section allows you to enable high-pass filters, low-pass filters, or both for all channels. The filter type, frequency, and gain can be entered manually or by using the quick start buttons on the left. Each output channel is color-coded and shown on the same plot to show a visual representation of how the channels line up with one another. Up next is the output EQ. The output EQ is identical in control and feel as the input EQ. It is recommended that the output EQ be used to tune a loudspeaker and use the input EQ to configure a room or venue. Following the output EQ is the output delay. The output delay is similar to the input delay, but has a maximum of 100 milliseconds. The output delay is best used for loudspeaker driver delay. The final output processing block is the limiter. The DCI Network Series amplifiers have incorporated the same high-quality level max limiters as the Crown USB 4CN and the iTech HD. The level max limiter looks ahead of the signal to more accurately predict when exactly and how exactly to limit the output. This revolutionary limiter algorithm greatly reduces potential for driver damage under any condition, as well as provide the best possible sound under limiting situations. Prevent having to replace speaker drivers by properly setting level max limiters. Following the output processing block is the amplifier settings block. Each channel has its own amplifier settings section that allows for monitoring of temperature, line voltage, clip events, and even load monitoring. Acceptable thresholds can be defined, and any potential errors can be reported through the network. Auto standby can be configured to put the amp channel to sleep after a user-defined period of inactivity to save even further on energy consumption. After the amp settings section is the SLM, or sweep load monitoring. The sweep load monitoring feature allows one to measure both the impedance of the load attached to the amplifier channel, as well as the frequency response through the internal processing. The results themselves are shown on the corresponding tab for each channel. To the far right is the speaker tuning section. The speaker tuning features allows for the output processing parameters to be saved, opened, and distributed. The speaker tuning section only saves the output processing blocks, crossover, output EQ, output delay, and level max limiter. By saving these settings as speaker tunings, a speaker or driver correctly set up on any channel of any DCI amplifier can be easily loaded onto any channel of any other DCI amplifier. When using speaker tunings, you still have the ability to tune the room or venue using the input processing section. The speaker tunings only save the settings specific to that speaker. Above the signal processing blocks is a signal generator window. The DCI amps allow you to access the internal signal generator for use during system testing. The signal generator type can be either pink noise, white noise, or a user-defined sine wave frequency. There's a master fader for the signal, as well as individual channel faders. Following the signal generator is the amplifier info window. The amplifier info section shows basic information about the amp, including model number, serial number, and the date it was manufactured. The amp status port can also be configured. The DCI amps also include pilot tone detection. With built-in pilot tone detection, venues can continuously monitor the speaker line for shorts, opens, or partial opens. This feature uses an inaudible 20 kHz sine wave sent to the speaker line and monitors the resulting current. If the current shifts outside the user-definable threshold, the amplifier will notify the user of an error. Thank you for watching this video. For questions, comments, or suggestions regarding this or any other video, please send them to the email address shown below. For technical assistance, please call the technical support department or email them at the options shown below.